Greetings, I'm Stan Houston. This is The Master Entrepreneur. It's Labor Day evening, and that isn't exactly what they said, but I arranged it just a bit and cleaned it up just a bit, but that was the thought. Yeah, it's been nice to have the day off, but tomorrow, on Tuesday, I have to go back to that job. I wonder if some of you are kind of feeling that way. Well, if that might be the case, perhaps I could be helpful this week. A few years ago, when I was doing a program on how to get a job, and I've got a number of ways you can get a job, and I can help you do that, but I also was asked, how do you quit a job? And so I put together a little program, which I went back and reviewed after a couple years, and it's still pretty good. And it was entitled, How to Quit Your Soul-Sucking Job. Well, if perhaps that's a little bit of your feeling, or if you know somebody who's having that feeling, why don't you give me just a few minutes this evening and let me go through some of the reasons you might feel that way about your job, and then what can we do just about that? Because I truly want you to be fully alive and to be a master entrepreneur. That's the program, and it begins right now. And indeed, we are back. Having a conversation that counts, usually that's about 12 to 20 minutes. Sometimes it's 10 minutes of clarity, and sometimes it's just a fast five so you can think about something and get on your way. But you've perhaps had a good day. It's always nice to have a Labor Day holiday. It's one of my better days because what I usually use it for is to kind of get myself recharged. It's kind of that symbolic feeling that now we're into the fourth quarter. We're finishing up the year, and perhaps next year we want to make it even more significant and make it better. And particularly, next year will be a diamond year for me, and 2020 will be a significant year for all of us. I guarantee it. There's going to be a lot of changes, and there's going to be a lot of obstacles, and there's going to be a lot of difficulties, and there are also going to be an incredible amount of opportunities, and I want to help you take advantage of all the best and perhaps be a better thriver and survivor when some of the not-so-good comes your way. Well, I sat down today, and I went through and said, why do people feel that way about their job? Now, the person involved here, first question was, well, don't you make enough money? He said, the money's not the issue. And he then confessed, he said, actually, I'm probably paid pretty well for what I do. Well, let's go through that. What are some of the things that actually go into a bad job? And I would encourage you right now to listen to this again, or perhaps just draw out a pen and nice pen. Draw out a nice pen. If you don't have a nice pen, get one. And a piece of paper. And let me list some of the things that might be causing you to say that about your job. Well, it could be that the pay really isn't very good, and it's just not working for you. So write that down. It's a job that the pay is not good enough for you, or it's just not right. Number two, maybe it's the people you are working with, you know, your colleagues, the compatriots. Maybe you don't even feel that way about them, but it just so happens that the people are not particularly the people you like to work with, or it just isn't energizing to you. Maybe the person you have to work for, you know, and boy, that's a key person. So pay, people. Maybe it's the product. You obviously are in a business that has a product. It is either a commodity, or it's a service, or it's an experience. That's the product. That's the thing that people pay you for. And that could be that the product just isn't anything that you're very excited about or care about or really have any great value with. You can produce it, and you can place it, and you can sell it, and you can work with it, but it's not really the product that does anything to you emotionally, psychologically, or even spiritually. So you don't like the product. Maybe it's just the place. The building, where it's located, where you have to go, where it's at. Just the place. Now, we're not talking necessarily about the people, but we are talking about that physical place where the people and the product and the work you do, where it's at. Maybe it's just not the place you like. A little higher level, maybe, you know, you kind of sit down and this was true of this person. He said, you know, I really couldn't care except for the fact that it's my job whether this place survives or not. I mean, and I said, you're not really in tune with the purpose. Yeah, that's right. I don't care. I wouldn't buy the product. I don't need it. Don't want it. Don't really care that much about it. But that's what this company is all about. And it just doesn't fit me. I mean, the purpose of the company. It's just not something that I care that much about. Well, the other, and now we're coming to number six, okay, was pay, people, the product, the place, the purpose. You're stuck. There is no promotion. And, of course, promotion means there's opportunities for perhaps you to have more responsibility, be more involved in work that makes a difference for you, matters for you. Maybe you can make more money, whatever it might be. But you know that you'll probably be doing this job because no one's going to move it around or move it up for you. It's just kind of the way it is. You know, you are in place and there's not a promotion that you can see. And so you combine that. Pay, number one. People, number two. Product, number three. The place, the physical place and space. The whole purpose of the business. There's no place for promotion. And number seven, it's just kind of painful. As one person said, I'm just tired of it. I'm just tired of it, you know. I've just been doing it too long. It's just kind of painful to have to go and continue to do that all the time. And that kind of covers a variety of things, doesn't it? But it's just kind of a pain. And maybe the pain is kind of the summary of a little bit of everything being off joint. But it's not a pleasure to be at work. It's kind of a pain to be at work. Those are all legitimate things, and if you're looking for career counseling and career help, perhaps I can help you do that. I do know that a number of my people can help you do that, particularly my good friend and colleague David McKnight, who is leading the Christian Entrepreneur Network, particularly in our Minneapolis-St. Paul affiliate in the Minnesota work. But his specialty is helping people discover what they're really good at. Maybe to discover what's right with them, in effect to discover the five words that describe their power, their strength. And it would be nice if you could have a job where the P word that you would have would be a sense of power. Things are working. Well, then that's something you should do something about, and you can. If going back to work tomorrow is pay, people, product, place, purpose, promotion, I'm just tired of it. It's kind of a pain. Perhaps you need to say, well, the problem with the job is me. I'm the wrong person for this job, and I need to find a right place for this person to be doing their mission, their cause, their work in life. Well, that's a good thing to do. And I would encourage you now that as we kind of bring this little 10-minute talk to an end, that you will think about this, perhaps play it again, but you will make a decision right now to reach out to us at radioedge77@gmail.com, radioedge77@gmail.com, and you would say, I need more counsel and care on that. Stan, you need to tell that message to a whole bunch of people. The seven things, maybe eight or nine things that are making it a bad job for you. I'm Stan Houston. You can reach out to me at tcenglobal.org and find out more about the Christian Entrepreneur Network, radioedge77@gmail.org. I hope this has been a helpful Labor Day evening for you. Tomorrow we're going to start talking about prayer, because maybe that's a part of what you need to do. And just so happened that last week I learned a whole lot more about prayer that just might change me and perhaps change you. In fact, it might change everything. And we'll talk about that starting perhaps on Tuesday or Wednesday. Again, this is the Master Entrepreneur. I would appreciate your help. Please raise your hand and say, "Stan, I'd like to be a part of your program. Stan, I'd like to help sponsor your program. Stan, I'd like to do something that will keep you over the top and on the air." I would be grateful if you would help us out, particularly as we go into a crucial fourth quarter for the work we do. And we, as a coach, will be able to step forward and help you as a personal business performance coach for you and your company. In fact, I can guarantee you right now that we could step forward and really help your people be more empowered to make their lives work better. And as their lives work better, your business will work better too. We can do that. I'm Stan Houston once again. They say it 3 to 7 times. I've probably done that too often. But we wish you all the best for this week, and we'll be in touch. Bye for now.